One of the most important classifiers is the convolution neural net for image processing, recognizing different images based on labels. It's a supervised learning technique. And what you have is, convolution is a sampling program. And what it's doing is looking at pixels around the current pixels and then averaging to get a value. And so it's an efficient way to do the sampling as you move across each one of the pixels, and it's fed into the neural net. So a lot of ways it works a lot like long-term, short-term memory, but because of its sampling of surrounding data points. And for that reason, it becomes an effective way of identifying objects in images. So in this case, what we're going to do is we'll set up a directory, and what this getStats function does is it will go to that specific directory where I have my images. It'll bring the image into a data array. I'll get some statistics on different arrays. So I'm going to have a heights array, a widths array, and an image count, and for each one of the images that are there. And so as you see that I can get the statistics. I have three files: apple, banana, orange, and my average height is 737 pixels. Average width is 829. My max height and max min height, so it ranges from 1198 pixels to 335 on the minimum height, and then the max width is 1360, min width is 450. So now what I want to do is I want to label each one of the image, and I'm using the name of the image to be used as a split. So I'll define the MP array and return which of the values. So in the first position it'll be apple, second position will be orange, and the third position will be banana. Okay, I want to load the data into my training data list, and basically it will then create an array of values that represent the image, and it'll be based on the image size, which will be 300. So I'll take the image, resize it, and then put it into an array, a list of arrays called training data, and then I'll return that train data set. So here I got train data, load the data, and then I can print out my array, and I can see that in my train data array that my identity matrix, I have apple, it looks like in this case it would be orange, and then banana. So it doesn't, the order is not specifically, it's how it's processing those files and then setting up that identity matrix. Okay, so now I'm going to reshape my array data into 300 by 300, and then this number 3 is your RGB value. And then I have my train data labels, which I can grab, and that represents my identity matrix. Okay, so then I set up my convolution neural net. I'll do a sequence model. I'll set the activation equal to RLU. Padding will be the same, and this kernel density, that's the number of pixels around the pixel that it'll look. So my kernel size will be 3, and so that becomes the sampling as it's convoluting over the image. And then my input shape will be 300 by 300 by 3, which should represent the RGB. Then I'll create a 32 neuron convolution neural net, set my dropout rate. My max pulling will be set to 2. Batch normalization will be added, and then I set up a second convolution neural net, and it's receiving the input shape from the first convolution. So at some point, it'd be kind of interesting to intercept each one of the layers and then print it out. Then you can see kind of the image that it convoluted, but it's generalizing the first in the first layer, then it generalizes again in the second layer with convolution of 64, and then in the last part I flatten out the results and use my softmax, and then I get three outputs with a categorical cross entropy, which will be whether it thinks it'll be an apple, orange, or banana. Okay, so now what I do is I have the, here's my structure. Just print a summary. I could have put it in a graphical form, but this summary shows you everything that you need to know about your number, the architecture of your neural net. Okay, then we're going to train the data against the image data and the label data, and we'll set a validation size of 0.2, and then we'll analyze the history of the training, and it'll tell us accuracy and loss. Okay, then we can just plot that out. Then we can load our test data, so you'd have another set of images that are similar to the images that you have trained on, and we can then apply that test and do a evaluation on it to get the accuracy. We can then predict it, and using the test images. Let's see, predict classes. Okay, so the one is predicting classes, the other one is doing a prediction. And then let's see. So in the output, it does predict banana. So in this case, the accuracy on it wasn't very good. And then I can take the model's layers and output them at the weights of the kernels, and then I can plot that image out to see what the weights are. And that would give me kind of an idea of maybe what's going wrong. My guess is that the shapes are difficult for it to recognize. Maybe it's not doing the edge detection very well, so it's not recognizing the object by the edge detection. Maybe it has to do with the color. And it could also be the number of cycles that I used in the training. Let's see, how many cycles did I use? So I did 10 epochs of training with my batch size of 50. So you have to, I got the CNN to input, but I wasn't able to get the accuracy up. And you want to be able to get your log loss to drop down. And anyway, so there's a look at convolution neural nets.